Hi, everyone. Thank you again for joining us for our introductory series to building web APIs with ASP.NET Core. Thus far, we've covered various topics such as what are APIs, what are they used for, and even seen some examples of different APIs that we can make use of today. In the last video, we took a look at HTTP and got an understanding of how it allows us to send information between two different places. Well, in this video, I think it's about time we take a step forward and see what it actually feels like to build a web API using Visual Studio. I've gone ahead and opened up Visual Studio 2019. The first thing that we'll do is select Create a New Project. That should open up the New Project dialog box. And we want to make sure that we find the ASP.NET Core Web Application template. Now, if you don't see this item, you can search for it in that template search box that's at the top. And if you still don't see it, go and check and make sure that you have the ASP.NET and Web Development Workload installed in Visual Studio. Now we'll hit the next button. And what we'll do here is give our application a name. So in this case, I'm gonna call it Contos for Recipes because I wanna create a recipes API. Now we'll hit create again. And on the next screen, we'll be presented with some options with the types of ASP.NET Core applications that we can create. For us, we wanna make sure that we have the web API one selected. Also on the right side, we're gonna leave all of the default options as they are. So that means that configure HTTPS and also enable open API support should be checked by default. We'll go ahead and hit create one more time. Now in the background, Visual Studio is going to take all of that information that we just entered and it will scaffold out a new ASP.NET Core Web API project that we could use. Once that's complete, we should see our project available for us inside of the Solution Explorer. Now, if you've ever done our ASP.NET Core 101 videos, this folder structure should look fairly familiar for you. So first off, you can see that we have our startup and program.cs files. Also, you'll see that there's a controllers folder, and inside of there, there should be a single controller called the weather forecast controller. If we open that up, we'll notice that there's a single method in here called get, and the job of this method is to receive requests for weather data and then return some response. Lastly, you'll see that we also have a weather forecast class. Now, the purpose of this class is to form the shape or the structure of the type of information that we want to return from our API. Now, let's go ahead and see if we could run this. Now, for us to run this in Visual Studio, we can hit this green button that's at the top in the toolbar. Or if we want, we can select the option of running it in Kestrel. And we'll do that by selecting the application name that's inside of this dropdown box. Now, that's the one I'm going to go with. And now I'll go ahead and hit that green button. After Visual Studio has loaded up our application and launched the web server, we should see a page pop up that looks something like this. I want us to pay attention to this blue box that's here that says get. And this is representing that get operation inside of our controller. If I hit this tryout button and execute, we should be able to see some responses that come back. So notice I get a 200 level response, and here's the information from the body of that response. And that concludes this video on how you can create new web API projects inside of Visual Studio. Now, stay tuned because next, we're going to learn how we can process requests inside of controllers and action methods.